The eggs.
He tried to stop me, but I took the carton from the trash, saying, "All of them?" I opened the carton and gasped. 6 whole, perfect eggs. Why'd you throw them away? He pushed past me and went around the house to the trash bin, and I followed him, waiting for an answer. He shook the garbage out, then turned to face me.
"Does the word salmonella mean anything to you?"
"Salmonella? But..."
"My mom doesn't think it's worth the risk."
I followed him back to the porch. "Are you saying she won't eat them because..."
"Because she's afraid of being poisoned."
"Poisoned? Why?"
"Because your backyard is, like, covered in turds. I mean, look at your place, Julie."
He pointed at our house and said, "Just look at it. It's a complete dive."
"It is not,"
I cried. But the truth was sitting right across the street, impossible to deny. My throat suddenly choked closed, and I found it painful to speak.
"Have you always thrown them away?"
He shrugged and looked down.
"Julie, look, we didn't want to hurt your feelings."
"My feelings? Do you realize Mrs. Stubbe and Mrs. Helms pay me for my eggs?"
"You're kidding."
"No, they pay me $2 a dozen."
"No way."
"It's true. All those eggs I gave to you, I could have sold to Mrs. Stubbe or Mrs. Helms."
"Oh," he said, and looked away. Then he eyed me and said, "Well, why did you just give them to us?"
I was fighting back tears, but it was hard. I choked out, "I was trying to be neighborly." He put down the trash can, then did something that made my brain freeze. He held me by the shoulders and looked me right in the eyes.
"Mrs. Stubbe's your neighbor, isn't she? So's Mrs. Helms, right? Why be neighborly to us and not them?"
What was he trying to say? Was it still so obvious how I felt about him? And if he knew, how could he have been so heartless, just throwing my eggs away like that, week after week, year after year? I couldn't find any words, none at all. I just stared at him, at the clear, brilliant blue of his eyes.
"I'm sorry, Julie," he whispered.
I stumbled home, embarrassed and confused, my heart completely cracked open. He tried to stop me, but I took the carton from the trash, saying, "All of them?" I opened the carton and gasped. 6 whole, perfect eggs. Why'd you throw them away? He pushed past me and went around the house to the trash bin, and I followed him, waiting for an answer. He shook the garbage out, then turned to face me.
"Does the word salmonella mean anything to you?"
"Salmonella? But..."
"My mom doesn't think it's worth the risk."
I followed him back to the porch. "Are you saying she won't eat them because..."
"Because she's afraid of being poisoned."
"Poisoned? Why?"
"Because your backyard is, like, covered in turds. I mean, look at your place, Julie." He pointed at our house and said, "Just look at it. It's a complete dive." "It is not," I cried. But the truth was sitting right across the street, impossible to deny. My throat suddenly choked closed, and I found it painful to speak. "Have you always thrown them away?" He shrugged and looked down. "Julie, look, we didn't want to hurt your feelings."
"My feelings? Do you realize Mrs. Stubbe and Mrs. Helms pay me for my eggs?"
"You're kidding."
"No, they pay me $2 a dozen."
"No way."
"It's true. All those eggs I gave to you, I could have sold to Mrs. Stubbe or Mrs. Helms."
"Oh," he said, and looked away. Then he eyed me and said, "Well, why did you just give them to us?"
I was fighting back tears, but it was hard. I choked out, "I was trying to be neighborly."
He put down the trash can, then did something that made my brain freeze. He held me by the shoulders and looked me right in the eyes. "Mrs. Stubbe's your neighbor, isn't she? So's Mrs. Helms, right? Why be neighborly to us and not them?"
What was he trying to say? Was it still so obvious how I felt about him? And if he knew, how could he have been so heartless, just throwing my eggs away like that, week after week, year after year? I couldn't find any words, none at all. I just stared at him, at the clear, brilliant blue of his eyes.
"I'm sorry, Julie," he whispered. I stumbled home, embarrassed and confused. My heart completely cracked open.
"내가 해석한 내용과 맞는지 확인하면서 다시 들어봅시다."
He tried to stop me, but I took the carton from the trash, saying, "All of them?" I opened the carton and gasped. 6 whole, perfect eggs. "Why'd you throw them away?" He pushed past me and went around the house to the trash bin, and I followed him, waiting for an answer. He shook the garbage out, then turned to face me.
"Does the word salmonella mean anything to you?"
"Salmonella? But..."
"My mom doesn't think it's worth the risk."
I followed him back to the porch. "Are you saying she won't eat them because..."
"Because she's afraid of being poisoned."
"Poisoned? Why?"
"Because your backyard is, like, covered in turds. I mean, look at your place, Julie."
He pointed at our house and said, "Just look at it. It's a complete dive."
"It is not," I cried.
But the truth was sitting right across the street, impossible to deny. My throat suddenly choked closed, and I found it painful to speak.
"Have you always thrown them away?" He shrugged and looked down. "Julie, look, we didn't want to hurt your feelings."
"My feelings? Do you realize Mrs. Stubbe and Mrs. Helms pay me for my eggs?"
"You're kidding."
"No,
They pay me $2 a dozen. No way. It's true. All those eggs I gave to you, I could have sold to Mrs. Stubby or Mrs. Helms.
Oh, he said, and looked away. Then he eyed me and said,
Well, why did you just give them to us?
I was fighting back tears, but it was hard. I choked out, I was trying to be neighborly.
He put down the trash can, then did something that made my brain freeze.
He held me by the shoulders and looked me right in the eyes.
Mrs. Stubby's your neighbor, isn't she? So's Mrs. Helms, right? Why be neighborly to us and not them?
What was he trying to say? Was it still so obvious how I felt about him? And if he knew, how could he have been so heartless, just throwing my eggs away like that, week after week, year after year? I couldn't find any words, none at all. I just stared at him, at the clear, brilliant blue of his eyes.
I'm sorry, Julie, he whispered.
I stumbled home, embarrassed and confused, my heart completely cracked open.